this one off by saying I am disappointed, but then again, it's news and I have to do it. So apparently there is something that's happening that I am just not quite understanding. I am yet to confirm it. I'm actually almost close to getting the full details from the right credible source. Now, I know I'd given up on my Queen of Katwe talk, but, well, when the slippers don't slip and the gossip mongers keep moving on, I would have a job every day, but these guys came up to me. Anyway, here's the situation. Remember Madina Nalwanga and what's his name? The boy, because they acted as brother and sister in Queen of Katwe. Now, there is a new controversy that has spun out of control, and I'm still waiting to talk to VJ Mark. Now, if all of you watch those, if you watch those Njogerere's, there's a guy called VJ Mark. Now, the situation here involves VJ Mark, Madina Nalwanga, that boy, Robert Katende, actually. Yes, he's called Robert Katende. And Mira Naira, not forgetting the full situation of Queen of Katwe. VJ Mark has been their guardian. Yes, Madina Nalwanga and Robert Katende have been living under his guardianship forever. It so happens that his parents used to work weird odd jobs. That is Katende's parents and Madina's parents. So they always used to come, Baba Sula, Wokuchibanda, Kumacha, Nabalabidida. He claims he's looked after these kids for about 10 years. Now, what's the story here? He is charging media houses an amount, approximately 500,000 Ugandan shillings for any media house to get an interview with these kids. Let it be CNN, you name it. He is charging 500,000. And on top of that, like, that is not bad enough. Apparently, the amount was set by Mira Naira, the person who actually produced the movie. Yes, she set the amount. It's there. You want them, you pay 500K. But here's the situation. It's gotten me confused. He says that this money is for the welfare of these kids. Now, these kids, he has not talked about where their parents are. All he does is keep collecting. He has not told the world which schools they go to. Last I heard, they're in some weird school somewhere there, Yomundange Kansanga. And it's all kind of funny for me because I would love to believe that these kids earned their spot in fame. They got the spot. This girl and boy were just lucky enough to get the spot. So I'm trying to find an equilibrium where someone can make me understand why you would be charging a media house to interview someone who honestly deserves the interview. They need their name out there. I feel like they are shooting down a star. Now, as I was still going through this emotion, it kicked in. Now, you know Ugandan parents. Once you have a Ugandan parent, they always remind you, nakukuza, nakulabidida, this is me paying back. But it doesn't honestly add up. Mira Naira, I don't know if this makes sense for you, given the fact you are half Ugandan. You must understand the situation in Uganda. I do not know if you honestly came out and acknowledged the fact that, yes, you pay 500K for every interview when it comes to these two. I do not know if you even know that they are actually extorting money from media houses. I don't know if you know that these kids had one shot at fame and they can easily get another shot if they are put out there. I think this is a way of selling these kids. You never know what kind of roles they're going to get again. So if you set this amount, I am sitting there and I'm like, wow. This is when the hashtag government Tuyambe comes in, because you could say it's kind of exploitation, but not exploitation in the right way, because these kids honestly agreed to being in a movie. They signed, Disney is paying them, but what about what happens after the movie? It reminds me that there's so many scavengers out there, and VJ Mark to me is one of them. He has not yet managed to even look for the official documentation to say that I am the real legal guardian. There is no documentation. Kati sente gwozitwalawa. Abana tebali masomero gali getulaba. They don't have their welfare up to par like it's supposed to be. So where are you putting the money? And besides that, where are the parents of these kids? If my child was a star in the latest blockbuster to hit this century, wouldn't I want a piece of that? Why is somebody running around claiming to be the guardian of your kids for the past 10 years? Who the hell are these people? And for these kids too, I don't know. I don't know what kind of dream Hollywood sold to you. But this is sad, man. It's sad. We have seen things like this happen so many times. You watch them in a Nigerian movie and you think that's the end of it. But at some point, I do believe these kids are going to be walking the streets of Kampala with absolutely nothing to their name. So for all of you out there, especially the Movie Association. Yes, I know you have an association. I think you need to reach out find out what exactly is happening with our latest treasures. Kenyans have Lupita Nyong'o. Yes, they won't say much about her because she's not entirely theirs, but she's Kenyan. And they will protect her at any one point. Why can't we protect our own? These are very young kids. And I think they deserve to get whatever it is that is coming to them. I'm just saying, those are my 2 pence. I'm throwing them there and let me wait. Probably somebody's going to hit me up and say, Tuchichusizam. But for now, it's a very, very horrible look. It's just disgusting to me. Remember when I sat here and I told you Cindy has a new man, blah 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 blah, Simanya Agenda Mwanjula? Yes, that's still happening, and she's coming out, she's like, we are just friends. Come on now, Cindy, come on, we know you. But here's the latest detail. So you see, I asked you guys, I'm like, Cindy doesn't do men who are single. Cindy always, she has a thing for bad boys. Now here's the latest. Somebody reached out to me and gave me this guy's entire life history. I think from when he was in diapers. I was like, whoa. What I can say, Cindy, for you, if you don't know yet, let me help you break it down for you. Do you know those bafere who can run game on you for a full younger? His dead end is just at the corner of the third year, after the first 1 year and the second year. That kind of thing. Now, Cindy's man is called Lubega. Here's the situation. He right now says he's a US Marine, which is not anywhere close to being, but here's the thing. Lubega was a regular Ugandan with no plot. Guess what he does? He looked for some money. He ended up going to Iraq. You remember those shipments where they used to send people to Iraq? Yeah, he went to Iraq. He made a little bit of money, came back to Uganda, started living a lovey-dovey, flashy lifestyle up in here, sent in a ziguawo. Was ziguawo? He asked for a second route. He went back. Money wasn't that good because that's the year that they actually closed off anybody going to Iraq for that kind of reason. He was doing security. Security UAE. So when he comes back here, Lubega nest like a problem until he decided, Sigenda kufira mumuvi yange, kanji yo muzungu. He went onto the internet, looked up for some Holy Christ church, and he sold his story. Boy, oh boy, did you sell your story. Ne yesi baku muzungu mpako muzungu boya mugambo manyi. Mukama akwagala, era akwagala America. Jiri nyenyonyi. That is how Lubega ended up being in America. But besides that, Cindy, I know right now you still think you have got yourself a trophy husband. When he went, remember, he had lied to them that he has accepted Christ as his personal savior. So all that time, this is picture evidence that I am going to share with everybody who is on Facebook. This is a Facebook thing for you. Go to our Facebook page. I am going to share photos with you of this guy sending all his Iraq former buddies. Some of them are actually still there doing other weird jobs. And he used to send photos of himself in church, praising and worshipping and everything. Now, how you happen to come and tell Cindy that you are a US Marine in the shortest time of 1 year, I don't quite get it. And Cindy, why do you get very overheatedly excited about men who just have a little bit of muscles and can wear a white nice t-shirt? Why? In other exciting news, now that I've actually noticed today I was just throwing way too much shade. I forgot it's a beautiful Friday. So in other exciting news, before I get to say bye-bye, Ann Consime has been awarded the brand ambassador for DSTV. Man, this girl, she just don't stop. I listened to her ad and she was talking about her and her ninjas and it kind of hit me. Why do we think Ann Consime is funny? Like, if she's not cracking a Muchiga joke in that Muchiga accent, there is no ha-ha moment. Like, I don't see it. And everybody tries to give Ann Consime credit for all the things that she is, until I found out that there's somebody actually ghostwriting for this girl. Now, I don't know if you guys understand. There is one person who is always on Ann Consime's crew. If she's flying out of this country, even if she's going just down here, to do a performance about her comedy or anything, there's one person, and that's the person who writes all her jokes. It's funny, she's not a Muchiga. All of you remember that chick, what's her name? You remember Cotilda? Chick who had long hair, then she cut it off, went bald. She is hilarious on stage. Yeah, baby. I got this news and I was like, Chichishino. How can all of you be so blind? So Cotilda, this is me officially saying you're on the winning team. Thank you for being there for Anne, but next time, honey boo pie pie, I know the money sells and everything. Own your work. You would have been far. come to think of it, Cotilda would have been where Ankansime is if she had honestly had some faith in herself. But hey, what was I saying? Kudos for you, you just want a bigger, you just got a good deal? Yeah, but I don't think she's that funny though, but that's it. Anywho, it's been my day here. Don't forget to catch me tomorrow. Yes, 10:30 in the morning. That's, of course, for Scoop and Scoop Extra. You can hit me up on my Twitter page. That's Atina Fierce One. Or you go to Facebook. Yeah, I am personally interacting with each one of y'all a day. You can also hit me up on the Urban TV Facebook page. For now, it's been my time. I'm out.